So okay, so I'm gonna show you some of my favorite creative tools that are unique to Baselight and how I use them. And I'm gonna use a couple examples of some real world projects that I just finished up a little while back. So one is texture highlight. It's a tool I generally use in a what I refer to as a look layer, and I love how I can organize my stacks and I can name them appropriately and how I can assign all of the tools, the creative tools that I have in my base light on each individual layer, depending upon what that layer's purpose is. So texture highlight is one tool that I like because it allows me to create these like beautiful, soft little light blooming things. So I can show you kind of like back here and where I can just basically, and you will see that if you look at the waveforms here, what it does is it kind of rolls these things off instead of pushing into hard clips. Very nice little things there that it's always just kind of handling my highlights and depending upon what I'm trying to do creatively. Another creative tool that I like a lot is the look operator. The look operator is, let me jump right to that right here, is basically allows you to load in already defined film print emulations from FilmLight, of everything from the entire area look library or various different generic film print emulations. They are nice in how they allow you to then take an image and just kind of give it a nice feel and bring in a lot of the gamut issues that are inherent to the video. And a good example of that would be, let me go back over to here, and just kind of go right to this shot right here and show you how one of the things that you might have like in the South where they shoot a lot of films, you get these really saturated greens because they're just super electric there. So what you can do is and you'll just see right away just by doing that, or actually here, just that's the change happening with just the film print emulation there, kind of bringing those line the bringing those in. You can also use a different one altogether here, and this is just a little bit more contrast. So whatever you ultimately feel like, the film wants or needs, you can and you can vary those amounts. It's a beautiful way of just kind of getting a film print emulation ultimately into the film, and quite little nice there. So just instead of your standard, just camera look. Another thing, let's see, tools I rely upon to facilitate collaboration work with my team. So, what we use actually is, let me grab a couple of things that just we've discovered that makes very handy. Oh shoot, I need to grab the web browser. So this thing called a client view that we are able to use during sessions. So here's an example. So client can look at this, or I'll often have somebody, a project manager for the DI, in the theater while we're doing a review or talking with things with the client, and they may say something like, as I'm on a shot here or something like that, that this one here maybe needs to put a little bit, make the teeth a little bit darker, or something's great about this that they otherwise like. So we'll just take those notes in here, and what this does is we'll put all those notes right into my database, into the timeline here. So then when I'm addressing those notes after they left, for example, I can actually create this shots tab, call it client notes, and find every shot that I created a client note on. And then I can see what the client note was, and I can ultimately flag those as completed and done. It's a way of communicating and keeping everything tagged right in the system. I can actually make my own notes right here as well. I say done, and just track a little log of those kinds of things, and it's really kind of a handy way of keeping track of that stuff. Another thing is specifically markers that you can then create various different categories. So if I'm gonna flag this for like VFX, for example, and let's say I needed them to create a matte for me or something, I can ultimately do that. I'll say need matte for teeth or something like that. So that my team can pick that up and know that that needs to be done, and then they can give me a nice matte. Although in this particular case, I could just do that. I did that matte entirely inside here with the paint tool, which is another fabulous tool that is just unique to Baselight as well. You can use paint strokes and basically just give me a nice matte here of the teeth as I tracked and created a nice little matte so that my teeth shape here, can be just darkened a little bit, give it that menacing ultimate feel that we want for the shot. Okay, so lots of great creative tools there, and there is a great way of collaborating with my team and with my client. We ultimately then can use some scripting to pull out all of those notes into a Google Docs sheet that's also shared and updated with about so that just helps the collaborative process. So let me tell you about, check this shot out here. How do I adjust noise and texture of the image? And that's, for this particular shot, here's a good use of that. I wanted to create this kind of pushed color, feel in it, bring up a lot of these hues back in here. And I did that with, on this particular area, just with hue curves, which is another great creative tool that can push hues without breaking them. But when doing so, if I did it in a very normal way, like this, so using the saturations, it's adding gain, and gain typically makes things noisy. So if I go ahead and just show you what I'm doing there, it's amplifying, you know, all these values and these colors and the saturation, and then when you do that, it actually amplifies the noise of them too. Which is not very pleasing. But if I use this thing called a texture blend, which is a blending tool, a layer tool that allows you to separate the frequencies in which this color tool is working on. So instead of working on in the higher frequencies, it's going to work on the lower frequencies. I can then push tools more, add more exposure or grain, or basically when I have something slightly underexposed, I can push it further and still keep it holding together. And so in this particular case, as you can see here, I can get a lot of color, but without and push a lot of like hues into there that I wouldn't be otherwise able to do that without it kind of getting noisy, especially on a big screen or a detailed monitor or an HDR or any of that kind of thing. So it's a way of getting, you're pushing your creative grades further without breaking the image. Another great tool as well is you'll see I created a layer called face texture here, and I wanted to get a little highlight onto the face, so you can see here just putting a little bit extra light source there. That's mostly done with this nice little thing called boost contrast, which creates a nice organic way of just giving you a little pop in the highlights here, a little contrast around it, and that feels very organic and natural, as opposed to just maybe adding only exposure or some gain or something like that. It just feels better. And so when this is, it feels like a natural little highlight hitting his face right there, as opposed to maybe just a little light only. So is there a Baselight hack that I would like to share? Maybe a keyboard trick? My Baselight hack is actually in customization, both in the what I put into the layers and how I then name those layers. You can go underneath to customize, and you can say save this layer's custom config. So each layer then that I use has a purpose of a particular tool set, texture equalizer, soften, you know, contrast, or other things like specifically maybe for a face layer, and ultimately my look operators or another look operator. Let's say if I'm going to use another airy RRT look without an airy actual RRT in the project setup, but the color management, then I could put that in there and I still have another look operator that I might use for a different purpose. So that is one thing. And the other thing is that I can't show you on this because this is just my laptop for Mac to record the screen. But on the Baselight 2 panel, I have a lot of custom mappings of what buttons and what places I like to push. So for example, copy paste operators of certain types that I use for smart copy paste, the transport controls, how I like those both left hand and right hand, also adding various different quick shape shortcuts for adding a shape, and I have on the panel there, to everything from adding denoise or deflicker as a just tools depending on. You can basically map almost anything onto the panel so that you're just very very fast and very efficient. Different projects also require different views or workspaces, and so one of the things I do animated film titles as well, would be to use this layers view, and I use it on a secondary screen, maybe along with a shots view to see these notes here about what needs to get done, and I can see that. And the reason why I do this is because when I do animated films, I might have 20 layers with all coming from the EXR file that I need to see which layers are controlling what, and they're also named appropriately. And it's a nice way to be able to visually see my stack in one way. So a lot of customized ways to customize the user interface. You can add in whatever you want. Hide that or something. So you can basically make your user interface appropriate for the job. So when I'm doing HDR work too, I do different scopes that are appropriate for that, as opposed to my regular stuff that I would normally do. Let's see, let's just hide that. And then yeah. So yes, that's a lot of customization unique to the job setup, unique to the stack setup, how I name or organize my stack, what tools go in the stack, even what color, how the color management is done, what working space in, or what the RRT I'm going to be using is. Everything is customized on a per project basis, depending on what the creative needs of that that project is. So, underneath here's a variety. If it was predominantly a Let Red show, maybe I'd want to use that one. Or maybe if it's I'm doing HDR and I want to be able to make sure that the theatrical version versus the HDR version really kind of matched a lot of similar tones, I'm going to be using maybe the TrueCam RRT, which I think is fabulous for that. And then maybe I'll be utilizing, if it's an airy show with that at the same time, I would then utilize the look layer here for adding the airy RRT and part of the look itself with a combination with that other RRT. So there's just a lot of ways to control things. Color space operator is another wonderful little tool. Color space conversion tool. Color space. So on animated films, sometimes I want to grade in a different stack space than how my input is or would be otherwise. It allows me to then easily convert that so my working grading space is within it. Or I might add a show LUT into the pipeline and then convert to color space, and so that my tools respond and work in a way that's wonderful. So there's just so many great ways to set up for each and every project and create really neat and interesting looks that are pleasing to the client. Let's see here. And let's see here if I can show you one more thing, how you can use some of these. And go back to here. And so just kind of show you, this is using the look operator to create a day for night, basically, and mixing that in with other things. But there you go, American Night, and just kind of helping bring in those nice deep blue tones to create day for night type stuff. And just make beautiful imagery. So I hope you like that. Enjoy. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.